So, my dear students, let us see how to solve the problems of induction motor. Okay. So now this equation we have derived. KVA input of induction motor is equal to Q is equal to C naught d square in NS, where C naught is equal to this, NS is equal to this. If output is given in terms of kilowatt, then KVA input can be calculated using this equation. If output is given in terms of HP, the KVA input is calculated using this equation. So finally, substituting this C naught and NS and Q, you can find out d square L. So to we have to use these ratios, L by 2 ratios, for various conditions: minimum cost design, good power factor, good efficiency, or good overall design, or best power factor. These ratios you have to remember. Usually in examinations, these ratios will not be given, and they will ask you to design for minimum cost design or good power factor, like that. And we know that peripheral speed, this is one of the check. VA is equal to pi d NS. For normal construction, VA should be less than or equal to 30 meter per second. For standard construction, it should be less than 60 meter per second. For special rotor construction, it should be less than 75 meter per second. Regarding ventilating ducts, if stator core length exceeds 100 to 125 mm, so a width of each duct is about 8 to 10 mm has to be provided. This has to be provided. Okay, for every 100 mm, one ventilating duct of 8 to 10 mm has to be provided. Then coming to stator design, first we will calculate turns per phase. Turns per phase. So this is a normal equation. Okay, EPH is equal to this. So now we want to find out this KWs. We know we want to find out TPH. So pi m we don't know. So that's why we should find out pi m first. Whenever you want to find out TPH, you start with pi m. You start with pi m. So pi m is equal to B average into area of the pole. So B average pi d pi b into L. So this is equal to B average to L. So from this equation, TPH is equal to EPH 4.44 F pi m KWS, or sometimes TS, ES notations are used. Okay. So like that you can find out TPH. So now, how to find out cross-sectional area of the stator conductor? Find out phase current Q in KVA multiplied by 1000 divided by 3 EPH. You get IPH. Now area of his stator conductor, AS is equal to IZ by delta S. IZ is nothing but IPH by A is number of parallel paths in stator winding. Okay, sometimes it may be one or two. So IPH you know. Okay, if parallel circuits are there, you have to substitute A is equal to 2, otherwise A is equal to 1 only. IZ is equal to IPH only. So like that you can find out cross-sectional area of the stator conductor. So here in this one we assume delta S current density 3 to 5 amps mm, but in the exam problem they will give the delta S. Okay, they will mention that. So coming to the calculation of number of stator slots, slot pitch YSS given by pi d by SS. So SS is number of stator slots. Usually YS, this one, it is 15 to 25 mm for open type slots, or sometimes it is 15 mm for semi enclosed types. So this we know, pi and d we have calculated. YS, either we have to select 15 to 25 mm or 15 mm. So by substituting this here, you can find out SS. You can find out SS. So now turns per phase is equal to ZPH by 2, total number of conductors per phase divided by 2. We know 2 conductors constitutes 1 turn. That's why conductors divided by 2 will give turns per phase. Therefore, ZPH is equal to 2PH or 2TS. So now total number of conductors is equal to total number of conductors for all the 3 phases. This is per phase. So for 3 phase, multiply with 3. 3 into 2 into TPH. So 3 into 2 into 2PH is 60PH. Now conductors per slot. So this is the total conductor, 60PH is total conductor, divided by SS, number of slots. So this will give conductors per slot, 60PH by SS. Okay, 60S by SS. Now area of this slot is equal to ZSSS into AS, this cross-sectional area, number of conductors per slot divided by space factor divided by space vector. Space vector will be given. Okay. ZSS you are calculated. ES you know. So you can find out area of the slot. So how to select the number of rotor slots? So these are the combination. It should not be equal to this. SS minus SR should not be like this. But to select this one, these conditions you have to consider. Okay. So number of rotor slots SR is equal to 3QR into P. Coming to rotor bar design, so bar current you can calculate using this equation. Then cross sectional area of each bar is equal to AB is equal to I. Once you calculate IB, AB is equal to IB by delta B. Delta B we have to assume, that is current density in the bar. Now coming to end ring, IE is equal to SR IB divided by pi P. SR is number of rotor slots, IB is the bar current, here we have found out. P is the number of poles, end ring current is found out. So cross sectional area of the end ring, AE is equal to IE by delta IE. Delta is the current density in end ring, ampere per mm square. So this also equal to depth of the end ring and thickness of the end ring. You can find out. Okay. Now coming to own rotor design. Okay, number of turns. Number of turns TR is found using this equation. So now rotor current is found using this equation. Okay. So here you have found out TR. Substitute here TR. In stator design you have found out this TPH and IPH. This is ISTS. Then you can calculate IR. You can calculate IR. Okay. Then cross-sectional conductor, cross-sectional area of the rotor conductor AR is found out using this one. Assuming delta R. In exam delta R will be given. Okay. Now coming to no load current. No load current we know that square root of IM plus IL square. Okay. How to find out IM? IM is equal to 0.427 P80/60 kWTPH. So total magnetizing current 80/60 is calculated using this equation. Okay, ampere turn required for the air gap, stator teeth, rotor teeth, stator core, rotor core. And IL, this IL loss component of no load current per phase is equal to IL is equal to total no load losses divided by 3 times VPH. Where no load losses is equal to iron losses plus friction and windage losses. And no load power factor is equal to cos pi, that is equal to IL by I naught, that you can find out. Okay. Now you'll see some typical problems. So now this is one of the problem. I will not discuss all the problem. This is a simple problem. So you can go through this one. Okay. So we'll see first problem. Determine the main dimensions and number of radial ventilating ducts, number of stator slots and number of turns per phase of a 3.7 kilowatt 400 volt three phase 4 pole 50 hertz squirrel cage induction motor to be started by a star delta starter. Working out winding details, assume average flux density in the air gap is 0.45 Weber per meter square, ampere conductor per meter 23,000, efficiency is equal to 0.85 and power factor is equal to 0.84. Machines rated at 3.7 kilowatt 4 pole are sold at competitive price and therefore choose main dimensions to give a cheap design. Okay. The given data 400 volt, 3.7 kilowatt, 3 phase, 4 pole, 50 hertz, B average is equal to this much and AC is equal to this, efficiency is this, power factor is equal to this. KW not given, KWC is not given, you have to assume. And here he told competitive price to give cheap design. So he has not given L by tau ratio. I told you have to remember L by tau ratio 1.5 to 2. Okay. So now main dimensions, to find out main dimensions, this equation we have to remember. You have to use this one. KV input is equal to kilowatt divided by n cos pi, kilowatt divided by n cos pi. Okay. So this 3.7 I substituted 0.85 for efficiency, cos pi 0.84. Now KV input we got 5.18. So using this equation, d square L is equal to q by c naught ns. Okay, so ns I have found out here, 2f by p, ns is equal to 25 rps. Okay, for every problem what they will do, first they will find out ns, this, and c naught. Later they will substitute here. Okay, so now d square L, after substituting this one, it comes out to be this one. Now for cheap design, L by 2 ratio 1.5 I have selected. Okay, it is 1.5 to 2 is there, 1.5 I have selected. So L is equal to 1.5 into 2. L is equal to 1.5, 2 is pi d by p. So now you will get L in terms of d, or this is, okay, L in terms of d. So here we have d square L, you substitute L, substitute L. So here L I have substituted. Okay, L I have substituted. So L is equal to 1.178 d. So from that, solving this equation, we get d is equal to this, L is equal to this. Okay, L is more than 100 mm now. This is in terms of 0.13, this is in terms of meter. This is in terms of meter. If core length exceeds 100 mm, a 10 mm radial duct to be provided. So net iron length Li is equal to, Ki is 0.9, this also has to be assumed. L is 0.13 meter. This is number of ventilators, one is sufficient. Okay. Breadth 10 mm. Okay. 0.01 meter. So this is Li is equal to 0.108 meter. So like this we can find out D and L and Li. Now coming to turns per phase, to find out turns per phase, this is important. As the machine is started by a star delta starter, it is designed for delta connection. Initially machine started with star connection, finally it goes into delta. It goes into delta. Means voltage across delta winding, whatever it voltage given 400 volt, it comes across delta winding. So in delta phase voltage is equal to line voltage. Okay, line voltage is given 400 volt. So here this equation we have to use. That is, phase voltage is nothing but ES is equal to 400. So we know this equation, ES is equal to this. Now here we want to find out TS, this is unknown. So KWS also, this KWS we know, pi m is unknown, pi m unknown. So pi m is calculated using this equation, okay. So you have to use this. So using this equation I have calculated, pi m comes out to be 5.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 Weber. Okay, then substitute here in this equation, this ES by 4.4 F pi M KWS, you will get number of turns is equal to 343. Okay, that's why in all the other, in textbook, initially they will start with calculating NS, okay, then pi M and C naught, because the later they are used in the these equations. Like this also you can, if you solve, no problem. So coming to the selection of number of stator slots. Okay. Now since machine is small, the slot pitch can be taken from 10 mm to 15 mm. 10 mm to 15 mm. Taking slots per pole per phase, QS. So QS is 3. Usually it is greater than 2. So number of stator slots, SS is equal to 3 PQS. 3, number of poles is 4 and QS is 3, here we have selected. So number of slots, stator slots is equal to 36. So now stator slot pitch is equal to YSS, pi D by SS, pi, this is D by SS, that is comes out to be 10.47 mm. So now total number of stator conductors 6 TS, so this comes out to be 2058. Now conductors per slot, ZSS 2058 divided by number of stator slots. So this comes out to be around 57. So now actual turns per phase is equal to, TS is equal to 36 multiplied by 57. This is conductors per slot. So multiply with 36, number of slots. Okay. And divided by 6, this will give actual turns per phase, TPH. This will give exhaust turn per phase TPH. This is TPH. Okay. Now number of coils to wound is equal to 36 by 2, 18. Number of coils per phase is equal to 18 by 3, 6. Okay, this is how to solve the problem. Okay, we'll see the second problem. Here, determine the main dimensions, turns per phase, number of slots, conductors cross section, and slot area of a 250 HP 3 phase, 50 Hz, 400 volt, 1410 RPM slip ring induction motor. Assume B average is equal to 0.5, AC is equal to 37, AC is equal to 30,000 ampere per meter, ampere conductor per meter, efficiency 0.9 and power factor 0.9, winding factor 0.955, current density 3.5 ampere per mm square, per mm square here, okay, per mm square, okay. The slot space factor 0.4 and ratio of core length to pole pitch is 1.2. The machine is delta connected. The machine is delta connected. Okay. So here important thing is that the given speed is given 1410 RPM. Therefore, nearest synchronous speed corresponding to 50 Hz is 1500 RPM. 1500 RPM. Okay. NS, it is given as 2F by P, 2F by P, okay. So, for P, for NS, okay, NS is equal to 2F by P, 2 into 50 by P, okay, or 120F by P, 120F by P. So, synchronous speed, capital NS in RPM, okay, this is equal to 120 F by P, 120 F by P, okay. So if you substitute two pole, P is equal to, it will give 3000. That is not the nearest synchronous speed. If substitute P is equal to 4, then it will give nearest synchronous speed is 1500 RPM. So therefore, P is equal to 4, P is equal to 4. So NS is equal to synchronous speed in RPS, 1500 by 60, 25 RPS. Now I told you find out C naught, okay. C naught is equal to this much. Then it is given in terms of HP. Use this equation. HP into 0.746 n cos pi. You will get kV input, that is 230.2. Now d square L is equal to Q C naught NS. Okay, Q naught you have calculated. This you have calculated. This you have calculated. So d square L comes out to be this much. This meter cube. Meter cube. Meter cube. Okay. So now, so here we have L by 2 ratio 1.2, L by 2 ratio 1.2, that is given. So here L in terms of D you will get, substitute here, you will get D this much and L this much, okay. So now coming to get winding designs, winding details, the machine is delta connected. Again ES is equal to 400 volt, phase voltage is nothing but line voltage. So same, use this equation. Okay, and here we don't know pi m. This is pi m is equal to B average into area. B average into area here. Okay, P m into B average into area. This is equal to this. Okay, pi m you will get this much. So using this TS you can calculate. So now TS is this. TS you are getting 32.4. So I will round it to 32. So total number of conductors is equal to 6 TS. That is 6 into 32, that is 192. So machine is larger, so slot pitch lies between 15 mm to 25 mm. So that is why SS is equal to pi d by SS, or SS is equal to pi d by, this is y SS. Okay, pi d by, this number of stator slots is equal to pi d by y SS. We know either 50, the slot pitch varies between 15 mm to 25. So number of slots lies between this pi d by SS, it is 25. Here I have substituted 15 mm, here it is 25 mm. So now number of slots lies between 50 to 83. So machine is large, since therefore larger number of slots has to be selected. So taking Q is equal to 5, total number of stator slots is equal to 3PQS. 3PQS. So QS I have selected 5. So total number of stator slots SS is equal to 60. So number of conductors is equal to 60S 192. So therefore conductors per slot is equal to, it comes around 3.2, rounding off we will get 3. So revised number of conductors is equal to 3 into 60 is equal to 180. Okay, because of rounding we have to calculate revised number of conductors. So to compensate this flux density, flux density has to be increased. Okay, because it is 3.2, we have reduced to 3, means actual number of turns are reduced, 180. Here instead, actually in 192 other, it reduced to 180. So to compensate that one, flux density has to be increased. Okay, now we have 3 into VPH, IPH into 10 raised to minus 3, okay, is equal to KVA input. So to calculate IPH, okay, this is ISR, IPH, both are same. Okay, this is ISR, IPH, both are same. Okay, both are same. So IS you will get 191.83, this is 192 amps. So area of stator conductor AS is equal to IS by delta S. This is given. This you have calculated, 55 mm square. The total copper area in each slot. So this is the area of one conductor and there are three conductors per slot. So total copper area is 165 mm square. So total area of slot is equal to copper area per slot divided by space factor. This is given, 0.4. Okay, this is it. Now this is how we can calculate all the winding. Okay. Now problem number 3 is similar, only here slot this condition he has given, this is important, IZ into Z, this check you have to make it, IZ into this, okay, this IZ into Z is the slot loading should not be great, should not exceed 500 amps, okay, this. So again here in this problem, you just see the read the problem. Okay. Now here everything is given, PF, KWS is given. Choose the main dimension to give best power factor. Again here L by tau ratio is not given. So best power factor, this is the equation that you have to remember. And slot loading should not exceed 500 ampere conductor. Okay. So in the same way, I have calculated this KVA input, okay, in the procedure. So here up to this D and L, so here D square L I have calculated, okay, to separate D and L, so this equation we have to use, tau is equal to 0.18L, after using this one, you can get length and D, okay. So now again using this EMF equation and pi m we have to calculate this one and TS we can calculate. So now in the problem he has given important this one we have to notice that it is star connected. See, this is the star connection. Okay, in the problem usually the line voltage is given, but voltage across each phase, That you have to consider. This is the ES, phase voltage across this winding, stator winding. So that's why this is line voltage divided by root 3 we have to do. If it is connected in star. Okay, if motor is working in star connection, so line voltage by root 3, that is the phase voltage. So this comes out to be this one. So this is important. If it is delta connected, use directly this. If it is star connected, you have to divide it by root 3. So this TS comes out to be 476. Again, total number of stator conductors I have calculated this one. Again, same thing, the condition, the slot pitch varies between 15 mm to 25. Okay, select, this comes out to be 98 to 164. The slots, number of slots comes out to be between 98 to 164. Okay, So now selecting QS, that is lots per pole per phase, from 2 to 5. Okay, for 2, number of slots. This number of slots is equal to 3 into P into QS. If you substitute here, 3 into P, number of poles and QS, you'll get 72. Here you'll get 108, here you'll get 144, here you'll get 180. Okay, so now, but our number of slots, stator slots should be between 98 to 164. 98 means this will this is invalid. 164 means this is invalid, 180 is invalid. Okay, either we have to select 108 or 144. So selecting this 108, so select SS 108, conductors per slot. So these are the conductors, number of slots are 108. So that SS is equal to 27. Okay, so now stator current per phase. Stator current per phase IS, this is RIPH is equal to this. Okay, this comes out to be 21.6 amps. Now slot loadings is equal to IS into ZSS. Okay, this is IZ into ZSS. IZ is conductor current. Since it is not mentioned how many parallel paths are there, so this IZ is equal to IS. IZ is equal to IS or IPH. IS or IPH. Okay. IS, IPH, all are same. So IPH, ZSS. So this comes out to be 583. But this exceeds the maximum specified limit, 500 ampere conductor, which is given in the problem. What is given? It should not exceed 500 ampere conductor per ampere conductor. So therefore, we cannot use 108 slots. So next, consider SS is equal to 144. When you consider SS is equal to 144, okay, conductors per slot is equal to 20. Now slot loading, IS, ZSS, this is the current, phase current, multiplied by ZSS. So this comes out to be 432 ampere conductor, which is below maximum limit. So we use 144 slots with 20 conductors per slot. Okay. Now here, this problem it has asked several times. It is given in HP, okay, specialty, and pole pitch equal to core length. This is given. Okay. Stator conductor, estimate stator conductors, and there are. Now conductors are connected in two parallel paths. See here, it is connected in two parallel paths. This is a special thing. Choose suitable number of conductors slot per slot so that slot loading does not exceed 750 ampere per conductor. Ampere conductors, 750 ampere conductors. Okay, so it is star connected. This is also, you can see here, this is star connected. Okay, so now whatever the data is given. Okay, we have to note it down. First data given. Okay, then what are the unknown things that you should write? Now this is normal. KV input when it is given in terms of HP. Okay, KV input you got. So NS, okay, NS is equal to 16.667 RPS. Now C naught is equal to this. C naught is equal to this. Substitute here C naught and NS. Okay, now this KVA input also you have calculated. You calculate C naught, NS, D square L you will get. Now D square L is equal to this. This you got 22 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube. So in the problem given, tau is equal to L. Pi d tau is pi d by p. That is equal to L. So you will get d in terms of L or L in terms of d. So substitute here in D square L here. Okay. Then you will get D and L. So again coming to TS to find out this one. Again here pi m we don't know. Use this equation to find out pi m. So pi m you got this one. And TS here you can see 415 by root 3. Okay, voltage by root 3. Why it is root 3? Machine is in, given that star connection. So line voltage by root 3. So TS comes out to be finally substituting this all these things 67. Since conductors placed in two parallel paths. So total stator conductors is equal to, see these are two parallel paths, but voltage across these two parallel paths is same. Okay, so now voltage across this path and voltage across this path, both are parallel. Voltage across parallel path will be same. So this will give TS. So total TS is this TS and this TS, you have to add. So 6 TS into 2, it comes out to be A04. This is important here. When given two parallel paths, so number of conductors are 6 TS into 2. Otherwise, it is only 6 TS. Now, slot pitch YSS should be between 15 mm to 25 mm. 15 mm to 25 mm. So this comes out to be from 44 to 74. 44 to 74. So now criteria QS, number of slots per pole per phase, this should be equal to, QS should be equal to 2 to 5. So SS is equal to, when you select QS 2, okay, so P we know, substitute this one. P is how much? P is, so 2 and 2, 4. 4. Okay, so then here QS is equal to 3, QS is equal to 339, P is equal to 6, P is equal to here 6, so P is equal to 6 here, P is equal to 6. So now here P is equal to 6, 3 into 2 6, 6 into 6 36, here it is 54, here it is 72, here it is 90, but in the problem the SS should be between 44 to and 74. So this is invalid. 36 is invalid, 90 is invalid. So considering SS is equal to 54. Considering SS is equal to 54. And SS is equal to 72. And SS is equal to 72. We can consider either of two. Okay. So now we know this basic equation. From this we can find out IPH. We can find IPH. So this IPH, nothing but line current, nothing but phase current. So this comes out to be 88.7 amps. So current through the conductor, that is important. IZ is equal to IPH by 2. This IS is there. This is IPH by 2. This IS is also equal to IPH. Okay. Now IPH. So now IPH, this is equal to 44.35 amps, since there are two parallel paths. Now check for the slot loadings. So one is SS is equal to 54 and SS is equal to 72. So now slot loadings with 54 slots, conductors per slot, 804 divided by 54. So conductors per slot is 15. Slot loading, this is the current into Z, 666 ampere conductors. And coming to SS is equal to 72, conductors per slot comes out to be 11, because number of slots are more, so conductors per slot will decrease. Then substitute here, this comes out to be 488 AC. Here it is 668. In both the cases, it is not exceeding. So in both the cases, slot loadings are not exceeding the limit. Limit is given 700 amps. Okay. So for lower cost, we select SS is equal to 54. Lesser slots. For low temperature rise, SS is equal to 72. Okay, so select SS is equal to 54, then ZS is equal to 15. Okay, so then total stator conductors is equal to ZSS multiplied by SS. This is equal to 810 stator conductors. New value of turns per phase is equal to 68. This is turns per phase. So that's over. Now, whatever the problems we have discussed, it is related to the stator design. Okay. So one problem will come on the stator design. Very simple minimum equations you can remember and you can solve those problems. Similar types of problem will come. Okay. So now here, we'll come to the problem 5. It is the problem based on rotor design, squirrel cage rotor design. So it is 11 kilowatt machine, 3 phase, 6 pole, 50 hertz, 220 volt star connected induction motor, has 56 stator slots, each containing 9 conductors. Okay, calculate the value of bar and end ring currents. The number of rotor bars is 64. The rotor bars is 64. The machine has an efficiency 0.86, power factor 0.85. Rotor MMF may be assumed as 85% of the stator MMF. This is given. Also find the bar and end ring sections. If the current density is 5 amps per mm square, current density is given. Okay. So note down this data: 3 phase, 11 kilowatt, P is equal to 6, F is equal to 50, 220 volt, star connected, SS 54, ZSS 9, SR 64. SR means 64 bars. Means in squirrel cage induction rotor, these bars are embedded in the slots. So number of bars is equal to number of rotor slots. SR is equal to 64. Efficiency 0.86, power supply 0.85. So now delta is given, 5 amps per mm square. So this is also given. Rotor MMF is equal to 0.85 times stator MMF, 85%. So IB we have to calculate, IE we have to calculate, AB we have to calculate, AE we have to calculate. Okay. So now we know this equation in bar design. IB is equal to this. Okay. Now turns per phase. We want turns per phase here. So SS, number of conductors per slot. Per slot, number of slot divided by 1 by 3 per phase. So this will give turns per phase TPH, or TS is equal to 81. Now this TS you have calculated. Now IS, phase current. So phase current can be calculated using this equation. Using this. Okay. In star, see this is a star connection. Root 3 VLIL in 10 raised to minus 3 KVA input. In star, phase current is equal to line current. Phase current is equal to line current. So find the KV input first. KV input is this. Then using this equation, you can find out IS. IS is equal to IPH or whatever it may be. Okay. This also equal to IPH or IL. Okay. All are same here. IL or IPH. Since it is star connected. Since it is star connected. Okay, so now substitute here, you will get bar current 258 amps and ending current using by substituting this bar current. Okay, ending current you found out, you can find out given delta is 5 amps per mm square. 5 amps per mm square. So area of each bar is equal to this, you can calculate, and area of each ending you can calculate this. Okay. That area of the end ring is equal to IB by delta. Area of each bar is equal to IB by delta. Area of end ring is IE by delta. So here IB, IE, no. IB, IE, no. You can find out this cross-sectional area of the bar and end ring. Okay. Like that you can find out. And this is also a similar problem. Like the previous problem. Okay, many unnecessary data is given, so I have solved in a simplest manner. It is a textbook solved problem, similar problem only. Okay, you go through that. Okay, here IB I have found out, here stator, TS I have found out, IB I have found out. Now, once you find out IB, AB can be found out. Once you find out IB, IE can be found out. So IE is equal to this, cross sectional area is equal to this. Okay, this is the simplest problem. To practice this problem. Now coming to the seventh problem, this is also solved problem. This is also has been asked twice. Okay, this is on wound rotor. This is on wound rotor. See, a 90 kilowatt, 500 volt. This is 500 volt, 50 hertz, 3 phase, 8 pole induction motor. Has a star connected stator winding, accommodates in 63 slots with 6 conductors per slot. If the slip ring voltage, this is slip ring induction motor, on open circuit is to be about 400 volt, Okay, this ER is given. Find the suitable rotor winding, stating number of slots, number of conductors per slot, coil span, slip ring voltage on open circuit. Approximately and approximate full load current per phase in rotor. Okay, these things we have to find out. Assume efficiency 0.9, power factor 0.86. Now this is the given data, 90 kilowatt, 500 volt, 50 hertz, 3 phase, pole is equal to 8, SS is equal to 63, ZS is equal to 6, okay, ZSS is equal to 6, this is ZSS is equal to 6, ER is 400, SR rotor slots we have to find out, rotor conductors per slot that we have to find out. So this equation we know. So KWR, KWS is not given or same we have to assume. So this get cancels. So TS, okay, if we take TR this side, TS can be found out. Sorry, TS, okay, this equation we know. TS we can found out. 63 slots, this is SS. Okay, this is ZSS, this is ZSS. Multiply total number of conductors you will get divided by 6. So this will give TPH. Okay, 63. Stator voltage per phase ES 500 by root 3. It is star connected. Okay. So 289 volt. Now for slip ring wound rotor slots should be preferably an integer. So taking 3 slots per pole per phase. This is one condition, it should be integer. So number of rotor slots SR is equal to 3 PQR. So 3 into P is 8. This QR is equal to 3 we have selected. Then it comes out to be 72. Using star connection for rotor, the rotor voltage at standstill ER is equal to, okay, it is star connected. ER is equal to 400 by root 3. So phase voltage is equal to, in the rotor winding, 231. So rotor turns per phase calculated using this equation. Okay, this both are same. So this is 231, this is ES 289, this is TS. Okay, so that TS is equal to this, then TR comes out to be this. So now total rotor conductors is equal to 6 TR. This comes out to be 300. So rotor conductors per slot, 300 by SR. So 4.16 comes out to be 4. So actual number of rotor conductors. So 4 into 72. This is the actual. Actually, this original value was this, but we have rounded it to 4. Now actual value will become 288. So actual number of rotor turns per phase. Rotor turns per phase comes out to be 48. So actual rotor voltage per phase at standstill, okay, so this 48 divided by 63 into ES, this comes out to be 220. The voltage between slip rings at standstill, root 3, this line voltage, 381. So now coil span is equal to slot per pole. Coil span is equal to slots per pole, okay. Slots per pole, that is 9 slots. Now rotor current per phase IR 0.8, this is equal to, you can see here, this is equal to SR into IR 0.86 ISTS. So IR is equal to this ISTS. Okay, in star connection IL is equal to IS is equal to IPH. So to find out IL or IS or IPH, we have used this equation. So using this equation, find out IS. IS comes out to be 134.36. Power factor is given 0.86. So using this equation, you can find out rotor current IR 151.6. This is determined.
Now we'll see this problem. Determine the magnetizing current, no load current and power factor of 15 HP, 6 pole, 440 volt, delta connected slip ring induction motor having the following data: number of stator slots 54, stator conductors per slot 28, flux per pole 8.25 into 10 raised to minus 3 Weber, air gap area per pole is 183.5 centimeter square, gap length is 0.55 mm, iron loss 510 watts, friction and windage losses 110 watts, gap contraction coefficient 1.33, iron parts of the magnetic circuit requires 20% of ampere turns required for air gap, stator winding factor is 0.96. So given data: 15 HP, 6 pole, 440 volt, delta connected, number of stator slots 54, conductor per slot 28, pi m given, this is Weber, okay, this is Weber, length of air gap 0.55 mm, air gap area per pole 183.5 centimeter square, iron loss 110 watt, friction and windage losses 110 watt, kg gap contraction factor 1.33, this is kws 0.6, magnetizing current asked, then I not asked. No, we know that no load current is calculated using this equation, square root of im square plus il square. Now im is calculated using this equation. Im is equal to 0.427 P 8060 KWS TS. So this TS we don't know, and 8060 we don't know. These two quantities we don't know. So first we'll find out TS. TS is equal to number of stator slots, conductors per slot. This will give total number of conductors divided by 6. This will give TPH or TS. Now we know that 8060 is equal to 80G. And ampere turn required for the magnetic circuit of the iron parts. So, because in the problem, see, we know that the flux passes through the air gap and other iron parts. Iron parts nothing but stator teeth, rotor core, stator core. So, in the problem they are given, ampere turn required for the magnetic circuit of iron parts is around 20% of the ATG. Okay. Now, ATG is equal to this. Now BG60 is equal to 1.36 B average. Now what is the B average? B average is found out by using this equation. So B average comes out to be 0.5 Weber per meter square. So then BG60 comes out to be 0.612 Weber per meter square. Now from that ATG60 can be found out. It comes out to be around 360 ampere turns. Okay. So now AT60 is equal to ATG and 20% of ATG. 0.2 into 360, this is 360 plus 0.2 into 360. This comes out to be 432.80. Now here, substitute this 8060 here and TS. So you will get 4.575 amps. Okay. Now calculate IL. PI is iron losses plus friction and windage losses. So this is equal to 510 plus 110 divided by 3 VPH. 3 VPH. This is delta connected. VPH is equal to VL. Line voltage is 440. So this comes around to be 4.47 amps. So no load current I0 is equal to square root of IM square plus IL square. If you substitute these quantities, you will get I0 is equal to 4.6 amps. Now no load power factor cos pi0 is equal to IL by I0. This 0.47 by 4.6. This comes out to be 0.102. So cos pi naught is equal to 0.102. So we'll see the last problem. Calculate the diameter and length and number of turns per phase, full load current and cross section of conductors. And total I square loss of the stator of a 3 phase 120 kilowatt, 2200 volts, 50 hertz, 750 rpm, star connected slip ring induction motor from the following data. B average is given, AC is given. Okay, B average is 0.48 Tesla, AC is 26,000, efficiency 92%, power factor 0.88. Assume L is equal to 1.25 tope, winding factor 0.95, current density 5 amps per mm square, mean length of the stator conductors 0.75 meter, resistivity of copper 0.021 meter and mm square. Now see, these are the given data. Okay, so now we know that Q kV input is equal to Q kV in kilowatt divided by efficiency cos pi. So you can calculate Q in kV input using Q in kilowatt. Using Q in kilowatt, this is the formula. Now NS is equal to NS by 60. NS is equal to NS by 60. Now this is NS is, this is 1500 here. Okay, this is 1500. So this comes out to be 12.5 RPS. 12.5 RPS. Okay, so C naught can be calculated using this equation. C naught can be calculated using this equation. C naught comes out to be 130.42. So now this, from this D square L product we can find out, this comes out to be 90.92 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube. So D square L is equal to this. Now we know they have given this relation. L is equal to 1.252. L is equal to this. Now from this P we can find out 120F by NS. P comes out to be 8. Then L is equal to 0.49D. Substituting here, okay, D comes out to be 0.57 meter. L comes out to be 0.28 meter. Now coming to winding design, we have this equation, basic equation, if ES is equal to, okay. So we don't know this pi m, okay, and TS. So pi m can be found out by using this equation. So substituting all those things, pi m comes out to be 30.08 into 10 to the minus 3 web. So now here it is star connected, okay, it is given in the problem, ES is equal to 2200 divided by root 3. Turns per phase comes out to be, TS comes out to be 200. Okay. Now this is the equation. Root 3 VL IL into 10 to minus 3. That is in KVA. Okay. This in star connection, IL is equal to IPH. IL is equal to IPH. Star line current is equal to phase current. Okay. So this. Now finding out phase current, okay, IS is equal to this, root 3 VL, okay. So now IS comes out to be 39 amps. The cross-sectional area of the stator conductor, AS is equal to current by delta, 39 amps by delta, 7.8 mm square. So AS is equal to 7.8 mm square. So total stator copper loss is equal to 3 times IS square into RS, okay. So we don't know RS. RS is found out using this equation. RS is equal to resistance per phase is equal to rho LMTS turns per phase divided by cross sectional area. So LMTS given 0.75 meter. This rho is given. Okay, TS is 200. ES is 7.8. So RS comes out to be 0.403 ohms. So total stator copper losses is equal to 3 into IS square into RS. So this comes out to be 1839 watts. Okay, this completes the module 4. So if you just go through the PPT, just send me any mistakes are there. Send me the feedback for mistakes. Okay, technically or typing mistakes, whatever it may be. And give the feedback for the further improvements. And send these feedbacks to my email ID. Or you can call to me. Okay. Okay, thank you.